Yellow, red, green. Slow down, stop, go. Looks like everything works up here.
Great.
Don't tell me you're still upset that the town council approved putting up this stoplight.
Stupid town council.
Aren't you on the town council, Barb?
Yeah.
So what?
Like, I don't vote it.
What do you have against this stoplight anyways? It's just here to make sure that everyone stays safe at the busiest intersection in our town.
Since when is the corner of Main and 3rd considered busy?
Ever since they opened that new interstate for miles north, we've been getting a lot more traffic come through town.
That's just it! They come right through our town. They don't stop by my store and buy groceries. They don't grab a burger at Polly's Diner. So why are we bothering to put up a stoplight? They're not going to stop. Just let them pass us by.
Like time is passing us by?
What's that supposed to mean?
Maybe this stoplight's a good thing. Maybe it means this sleepy old town is finally moving up in the world.
Trish, I never figured you to be one of the big city types.
Neither did I.
I thought you were one of us.
Who's us?
You know, us. The us that have lived here for generations and run the shops and the restaurants. The us that sit outside on hot days drinking icy glasses of lemonade and playing endless games of checkers with our neighbors. The us that know the name of every kid in town and aren't afraid to call them out when they get a little rowdy. The us that think things here in town are perfect just the way they are and don't see why things have to change.
Barb, I am one of us. But I also happen to really like this new stoplight.
I don't see what's so great about it.
Well, when the light turns yellow, it means we have to slow down and check out our surroundings. It turns red when things aren't safe, and we need to take a few moments and stop. But when that light turns green, we know all is well, and we're free to head off in a new direction to whatever life has in store for us. I don't know about you, but sometimes I need a little reminder to slow down, stop, and take in all the great things life has to offer us in this town. But also that there's a great big world out there, and it's okay to go explore it.
I don't need to go exploring. Everything I need is right here.
That's great, Barb.
You know, people are going to hate that stoplight. They'll want it taken down, you know.
Only time will tell, Barb. Speaking of, I gotta go. Polly's oven's on the fritz, and she'll have my head if I don't get over there to fix it before the breakfast rush.
The whole town will have your head if you don't get their breakfast.
Ain't that the truth? See you later, Barb.
See ya, Trish.
Stupid stoplight.
Uh-oh, she just put that up. Oh my God, Trisha's gonna kill me. Sorry, I didn't mean it, I swear.
Who you talking to, Barb?
You ain't talking to that stoplight, are ya, Barb?
Did you guys see that? It's flashing red because I threw a flyer at it.
Looks fine to me.
It looks fine to me, too.
It was flashing red just a minute ago, I swear.
Sure thing, Barb.
Whatever you say, Barb.
Stupid stoplight!
You saw it flashing at her too, didn't you, Maude?
Sure did, Clarence. Sure did.
That's a good one, Chuck. I bet he never even saw it coming.
No way. You better hope Mr. Schmidt doesn't find out. What about you, Bill? You and Lucy look pretty cozy. Yeah, well, does she know that? You know me? The ladies at Central High love them some gym. Yup, even her. She may have played it cool with dance, but Sally is desperately in love with me.
Is that so?
Oh, Sally. Didn't see her.
Yeah, gathered that.
How long have you been standing there?
Long enough.
Guys, I've got to go. Hey, Sally, wait a minute, won't you?
How could I resist? After all, I'm desperately in love with you. Isn't that right, Jim Matthews?
I was just joking around with the guys, Sal. You know how it is.
No, I don't. But I'd love to hear more. Enlighten me.
You see.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
Won't you at least let me apologize?
But it's not necessary.
Yes, it is. I don't want you to think that's the type of guy I am.
You do not want to know the kind of guy I think you are.
What's that supposed to mean?
You're the kind of guy who makes jokes with the bow I wear in my hair.
Are you serious?
You're the kind of guy who calls me a brainiac when I raise my hand and answer a question.
That happened one time. Okay, maybe two. Okay, maybe more than two.
You're the kind of guy who teases me because my dioramas are too good.
You make the rest of us look bad. Did you have to make a working oil rig? Complete with realistic pumps and moving trucks.
I can't help being detailed-oriented.
Detailed-oriented. Detailed-obsessed is more like it.
If you're content with a measly A-minus, who am I to stop you? So, if you want to know the kind of guy I think you are, now you know.
Yeah, well, you aren't exactly green bean queen material yourself, you know.
What's that supposed to mean?
You're the kind of girl to make fun of a guy for spilling milk on himself at lunch.
You've always been a sloppy eater.
You're the kind of girl to make fun of a guy when his science experiment explodes in his face.
That's right. You were missing an eyebrow for the entire third quarter.
Got you with this one. Got you with this one. You're the kind of girl to make fun of a guy for not getting the lead in the school play.
It wasn't that you didn't get the lead. It was the part you did get.
I had a cold.
So you said.
I was sick. I couldn't stop coughing and sneezing.
Sure.
It was the only reason the director didn't give me any lines.
Jim, you were literally a gate.
I'll have you know, the gate was a pivotal role in our production of Our Town.
You know, pivotal is right.
That was years ago.
It was last year.
Yeah, well, you've been picking on me ever since freshman year.
So what? We already established you pick on me too.
Sure I did. Back in second grade, you're the one still holding a grudge.
How dare you?
I picked on you when we were eight. We were children.
You act like a child now.
There you go. You just can't help yourself, can you? Here we are, all these years later, underneath this stoplight, and you still can't stop calling me names.
That's because you started it.
I really liked your bows, you know.
Yeah, well, I think it's kind of cute you're a messy eater.
And I really, really liked how smart you were.
Yeah, well, I kind of liked when you only had one eyebrow. It made you look a little mysterious.
And I really, really, and I mean really liked your diorama of the oil rig. I was hoping you would ask me over after school so I could get a closer look.
I thought you made a wonderful gate.
Can we call a truce then?
How do we do that?
How about a dance?
So, does this mean we can't stop teasing each other anymore?
Now, when did I say that?
Well, you're seriously a terrible dancer. Do you have two left feet or something?
Oh, and I suppose the brainiac like you could teach me a thing or two about dancing.
You know it, unless you're trying to break every one of my toes. Think you and I are going to need to get together a few times next week for some dance lessons.
You know what I think?
What?
I think you're desperately in love with me.
Of course you do. No, it's left, right. You're not doing it right.
Left,
no.
Right.
No, that's
doing
not.
It right.
No, you're not, Tim.
Smell of burning rubber.
The wind in my hair. Oh, this one is mine. I can just feel it. So, what are the terms?
All right, we start right here. Go around the stoplight and finish back here.
First to the finish line wins.
First to swerve his chicken.
You look so silly.
Yeah, well, your friend looks like a chicken.
Stop it.
Are you guys sure this is a good idea?
I think it's a great idea.
The best.
This can be dangerous, you know?
Danger doesn't scare me.
Yeah, and danger is my middle name.
Your middle name's Winston.
Shut up!
But we're in the middle of the street. There could be cars coming by. We could get hit by a bus.
So? They'll just have to go around us.
Yeah, we were here first. Plus, we'd be way too fast for them to catch.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. I'm faster than you.
No, I'm faster than you.
We'll see about that.
Wait a minute. What are we racing for?
Pinks?
Pink slips.
Right. Winner gets ownership of the loser's wheels.
Like for keeps?
For keeps.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. We did not decide on those. Those are harsh terms.
Okay, first of all, we decided on them. You're not going to back out, are you?
I would never.
Good, because I've been wanting a new pair of wheels.
You're going to have to ask Santa Claus, because you're not getting mine.
You better be hungry, because you're going to eat my dust.
You'll be coughing up my dust for literal days.
Oh,
okay, girl, save it for the race.
What's going on over here?
Nothing for you to worry about.
Looks like you kids are having a disagreement.
We ain't kids, Trish.
And we ain't having a disagreement. We're about to drag race.
So, what are you racing for?
Pink slips.
I see.
You don't approve?
I didn't say that.
I tried to talk them out of it, but they weren't having it.
Are the vehicles road ready?
I just gave mine a tune-up. Yesterday.
And mine is brand new. I just saved enough money to get her yesterday.
I see. And I trust you've scouted the course.
Obviously, Trish, this is Main Street. We know it like the back of our hands. See?
Very well. Then I guess you kids are ready to race.
Wait a minute. Do you have any last minute words of wisdom?
Only this. When racing around the circle of life, we should not only seek the rewards that can be found in taking risks, but also the rewards that can be found in taking your time.
What do you even mean?
It's me. I think I get what she's trying to say.
Well, that makes one of us.
Okay, enough of this tongue wagging. I came here to race.
Yeah, let's get on with it already.
I'm ready.
I was born ready.
You better shake on it.
Fine.
The deal's been struck to your vehicles.
Whoa, 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 whoa. You do not want to stick around for this trip. It could get ugly.
I'm not going anywhere.
Start your engines. Whenever you're ready.
I'm just waiting until the light turns green. Girls, please. In 3, 2, 1, go!
And they're off.
Look at them go.
Oh, I can't watch.
I got to lead.
But my guy's pulling ahead.
Why is that guy slowing down?
Watch out before you hit the... You know, you didn't even finish.
It's okay. I guess we could always have a rematch.
You are not really going to race again after what just happened.
I said we could. I didn't say when. Plus, I think I found that there's valuable rewards to be found in taking my time.
Day today, eh, Maud?
You got that right, Clarence. Not the usual hustle and bustle here on Main Street.
I heard church bells ringing a little while ago.
It must have been that Matthew's wedding. You know,
kids. They started dating a few years back in high school.
Oh, right. That one was today.
Oh, it sure was. Whole town got invited.
I didn't get an invitation in the mail. They must have forgotten me.
They didn't forget you. It was an electronic invitation. An evite.
What's an evite?
I just said, it's an electronic invitation. They send it through your email. Do you never listen?
My email invited me to the Matthews wedding.
Oh, Clarence. Jim and Sally sent the invitation using email.
Why would they do a thing like that? I don't check my email. I don't even know if I have an email. Do you have an email, Maud?
Everyone has an email, Clarence.
Oh.
All right, here it comes.
Oh, hey, guys, we didn't see you at the wedding.
Our invitations must have gone lost in the mail.
But we emailed the invitations.
Exactly.
We did invite them, right?
Yeah.
Anyway, we'll show you pictures after our honeymoon.
See you guys next week.
Don't do anything I wouldn't do!
If they do that, that'll be one boring honeymoon.
Oh, what do you mean I'm romantic?
With who?
Oh, I've got lots of lady friends.
Is that so?
Oh, it sure is.
I'm gonna need to see some proof, Mom.
Oh, I'll get you some proof. Oh, with Casey.
Hey there, Casey.
Oh, hi, Clarence.
Gonna cross the street anytime soon, Casey?
I'm thinking about it.
What's the holdup?
I'm just waiting for the right time.
Well, when is that right time?
When I am ready.
Oh, hey there, Casey.
Hi, Trish.
Where are you headed?
I'd like to go to the drugstore. I heard Loretta's got some new lemon candies in stock that are really good.
Oh, you heard right! Those lemon candies are delicious! Remind me to get some of those later.
I heard you ordered them all the way from England. They're called sherbet lemons, Casey.
I thought sherbet was a kind of ice cream.
Not in England, I guess, Maud.
Well, did you know that in England they call a car's trunk a boot?
Yeah, real funny.
And they call a baby's pacifier a dummy.
Oh, really? I would have thought they called it a mod.
It's safe to cross now, Casey.
Not yet.
But there's nothing to be afraid of. There aren't even any cars coming.
There's never any cars coming, Trish. Not since the day you installed that stoplight.
I am not afraid.
Then what are you waiting for?
My moment.
Now that makes sense.
It does.
Of course. Sooner or later, Casey's moment will come. And when it does, she'll cross the street.
That's right.
We don't always know when our moment will arrive, but when it does, we just have to be ready.
I think I'll try again tomorrow.
Same time, same place?
Sounds like a plan.
See you tomorrow, Casey!
My cue. See you later, fellas.
See ya, Trish.
So, back to those lady friends of yours, Maud.
What about them, Clarence?
When am I gonna get to see that proof?
You know what? I'll email you.
Protesting for today.
Stoplight coming down.
But it's not coming down. It's right there.
Not if Barb has it her way.
What do you mean?
You haven't heard? Barb's running for town councilman. Promise of taking that stoplight down.
Again? She's been trying to get that light taken down for years with no success.
Yeah, well, we won't let that happen now, will we? What do we want?
Who said you can congregate outside of my store like this?
They have a right to be here, Barb.
Yep, Barb. This street belongs to all of us. Just like this town and this stoplight.
You and your stoplight can get out of here, as far as I'm concerned. This darn stoplight has caused this town
nothing but trouble since it was installed.
How do you figure that, Barb?
Every time I try to cross the street, it turns red.
That's just bad timing.
Fine, but what about that time it stayed on yellow for 20 whole minutes? At the exact moment, a bunch of loud, gas-guzzling motorcycles drove through our town. They were all going about 5 miles per hour, waiting for the light to turn red. I was fanning exhaust out of my store for hours.
Barb, I told you there was a shorted circuit in the light. I fixed it as soon as I heard about it.
Fair enough. But what about that time I was making that delivery to Polly's?
Forgot about that one.
I had a cart full of produce for Polly. Every time I took a step to cross the street, the light turned from green to yellow to red and back to green again. There I was, running back and forth from the street to the curb like a deranged squirrel. My produce was flying in every direction.
That's just hilarious.
I looked like a darn fool.
You said it, not me.
It's out to get me, I tell you.
Okay, we do not need to protest anymore.
So you believe me? You're on my side in this?
Whoa, not in the slightest.
I don't understand.
I'm not worried about that stoplight coming down anymore, because you're not winning the election.
And how do you figure that?
Half the town saw you running around trying to make that delivery to Polly's looking like, deranged squirrel who doesn't know she's coming or going. No one wants that. Good luck, Barb.
Hey, Barb.
Yeah?
You should probably find a different issue to run on than getting that light taken down.
But this is my platform.
No, Barb, it's actually your soapbox.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. So you're telling me that I'm standing on a soapbox because I'm passionate about getting rid of this stoplight?
Nope. I'm telling you you're standing on a soapbox because you're standing on a soapbox. Looks like it's mountain air fresh.
Fine, I'll come down off this box, but I'm not changing my platform.
That's your right, Barb.
And I'm going to keep campaigning to get rid of the stoplight.
Wouldn't expect anything less.
And when I become head councilwoman, that stoplight is coming down.
Only time will tell, Barb. Speaking of, I gotta go. Clarence got a new computer, and he needs my help setting up his email. I guess Maud convinced him that if he opens his spam folder, processed meats will shoot out of his monitor.
Clarence got a new computer?
Yep.
He'll be keeping you busy with that one for sure.
That's the truth. See you later, Barb.
See you, Trish. Stupid stoplight. Oh, not again!
Bus gonna get here already. Come on, hurry up. Excuse me, miss. Did you just get off the 7:30 bus out of town?
No, sorry, I didn't.
But you have a suitcase with you.
I do.
So you must be from out of town.
I am. I took a taxi.
Oh. I can't afford a taxi. I guess I'll just have to wait for the bus.
I'm sure the bus will be here any minute.
Shows how much you know. The bus rarely comes through here. This town is too small to be included on the normal route.
But you have a stoplight.
A broken stoplight. It's been stuck on red for 20 minutes.
Still, if you have a stoplight, that must mean you're getting a decent amount of traffic from the interstate.
Wow. You really aren't from around here, are you?
Actually, I am.
That's not true. If you were from around here, I'd know you. This town is so small that everyone knows everyone.
It's been a long time since I've been home.
You mean, you escaped? You actually got out?
I did.
Tell me, how'd you do it?
One day I packed a bag and left, simple as that.
And you never looked back?
Not at first. I loved living in the big city, going to work all day, coming home to my very own apartment at night, trying new food, seeing new movies, meeting new people.
That sounds amazing. No one in this town has even heard of culture. Right now the cinema is playing a double feature of Groundhog's Day, and what about Bob?
Great flicks, Bill Murray's the best!
Slapstick comedy, gross-out humor, whatever happened to classics like Breakfast at Tiffany's or Mean Girls?
Mean Girls, a classic?
You know what I mean.
True, there is a lot of culture in the city, but there's also a lot of noise and dirt and loneliness.
How can that be possible? There's way more people in the city than there are here.
Yeah, but in the city, everyone's always coming or going. You could walk the streets all day and not see a single person you knew. No one takes a minute to slow down or even stand still. I guess that's why I came back. I just needed to stand still for a little while.
But I don't want to stand still. Not here, at least. I'm just so sick of everything. The stupid stoplight, the town, the people.
The people? I always thought the best thing about living in a small town was how nice everyone was.
Too nice, if you ask me.
Is there such thing as too nice?
Yes, I feel as if everyone around me is an alien disguised as a human. Sure, they may walk like us, talk like us, even act like us, but deep down inside, under their human skin, lurk aliens.
Like the Body Snatchers.
The what?
The Body Snatchers. You know that old black and white sci-fi movie?
Black and white? You're really, really old.
And here I thought you were so cultured. Invasion of the Body Snatchers is a movie about a town overrun by aliens known as pod people. They use their pods to transform from alien to human. They then use their new forms to assimilate into everyday life, going unnoticed, looking exactly like everyone else.
Yes, that's it. That's exactly how I feel. I feel as if everyone around me is a pod person, and I'm the only one who knows who they really are. Now, she's definitely a pod person.
I remember feeling the same way you feel about this town.
So you get it. You understand why I have to go.
The thing about pod people is they're devoid of human emotion, such as love. It's the one thing they couldn't replicate. And if I remember correctly, the people of this town have plenty of love to spare.
Now you're starting to sound like a pod person.
Maybe I am.
And if this town were overrun by aliens, at least it'd be something new for a change. Everything's just same old here. There's Barb's grocery store selling the same old chicken and potatoes. Does everything she sells have to be an ingredient for a casserole? How about some ethnic foods from foreign lands? Heck, I'd even take a medium spicy salsa.
Whoa, slow down there, stranger. Let's not get too wild.
Or Loretta's Pharmacy, where the only crazy thing to ever happen there was when she started stocking in lemon candies from England.
Well, you did say you wanted foods from foreign lands.
Or the cinema, which refuses to play a movie from this century.
You got me there. Bill Murray's a genius, but there are plenty of movies not starring his comedic talents you guys are missing out on.
And there's Polly's
Diner.
I have
to stop you right there. Polly's is fine, just the way it is.
How would you know? You haven't been here in years.
Polly's is an institution. The club sandwiches, the chocolate malts, the french fries. Oh, I've been dreaming of those french fries for as long as I can remember.
Those fries are pretty good.
And plus, there's something nice about knowing exactly which store is going to have your favorite lemon candies.
She makes sure she has enough for the whole town.
And some of the boring ingredients, such as chicken and potatoes, are the thing that lead to inspiration. Hey, some of the best dishes I had in the city were made from chicken and potatoes.
I have looked up a few recipes online, and I guess I could try them.
And if you haven't seen Groundhog Day, well, there's nothing more I can say to you.
All right, I'll see Groundhog's Day.
And what about Bob?
Baby steps there.
So, are you staying?
I just don't know.
I'm sure there'd be a lot of people who missed you if you left.
Pod people.
Maybe. Maybe not. All I'm saying is there are reasons to stay and there are reasons not to. Life is not as simple as that stoplight. You can't be having a light one telling you when to stop and when to go.
But I don't have that now. If I let the stoplight decide, I'll be stuck here forever.
There's decisions to make, and you just have to make sure you're making them for the right ones. I know you think there's so much life out there that you want to live, but is that worth giving up everything you have right here, right now? Hey, kind of late for a stroll, isn't it?
Tell me about it.
It's the only thing that'll put her to sleep. My wife is catching up on some Z's while I take the baby out for a walk. She finally fell asleep a few streets back.
You look exhausted.
I'm so tired.
I barely even remember my own name. I think it's Jim.
Well, nice to meet you, Jim. Now you stop walking, though.
I'm afraid if I stop moving, she'll wake up.
Well, you gotta stop moving sometime.
That remains to be seen. Is this light ever gonna turn green?
I think it's broken. It's been stuck on red all night.
What else is new? Pierville got that stoplight a few years back, expecting there to be all this traffic. Guess some things never change.
I guess not.
Well, good night.
Good night. So, what did you decide?
I guess I'm gonna stay, but for now.
Really? What changed your mind?
I guess if I'm gonna be leaving this town, I want it to be because I'm running towards something, not running away from it.
I wish someone gave me that advice before I left town.
Do you think you would have stayed?
Who knows? All I know that this is where I want to be, right here in this moment.
Well, I better get home before my mom and dad start to worry. Good luck assimilating with the pod people.
You too. Hey, good evening. Light's broken. It's stuck on red.
I see that. It's all right. I'll have it fixed soon enough.
All right, well, have a good night.
You too. Hey, wait. Do I know you? You look familiar.
I get that a lot. I guess that's what happens when you come from a small town.
Maybe so.
Well, sorry I have to be out working so late.
Oh, I don't mind. It's a beautiful night. The kind of night that makes you want to slow down and take it all in. You know what I mean?
I think I do. Night.
Good night. Well, that should do it. Now to see if it works or if we're stuck on red forever. Yellow. Slow down. Don't mind if I do. Got ourselves a green light. Time to start the day. Good morning, Clarence. Maud.
Morning, Trish.
You two are up early.
It annoys Barb when we sit outside her shop all day.
So naturally, we've gotten to getting here the moment she opens.
You two are terrible.
What are you up to today, Trish?
Barb needs some work done. Her produce bears aren't really working right. All they do is drip.
Barb's a drip.
Is that all you two do all day? Sit out here and comment on everyone in town?
Basically.
Carry on then.
Wait, Trish. When you're fixing Barb's produce sprayers, if you get a moment, could you give Barb a little shower, courtesy of her good friends Clarence and Maud?
I'll see what I can do.
Oh, you know Trish would never do something like that.
A man can dream, can't he?
Where is everyone?
Oh, I'm right here!
I mean everyone else.
What am I, chop liver?
I mean the rest of the parades, the families, the crowd, the marching band. They should have all been here by now.
Wait a minute, are you the green bean queen?
At your service.
So you're here for the annual Harvest Festival Day Parade, then?
Yes, I am. They told me to be right here underneath the stoplights.
Yeah, that ain't till next week.
No, it's not. It's today.
Clarence is right for once. It's not till the 19th.
But today's the 19th.
I'm afraid it's not.
You gotta be kidding me. I got all dressed up for nothing?
Yeah, you did.
So mean.
Well, this is just great.
Where do we line up?
If you're here for the parade, then you're out of luck.
Parade's next week.
Can these people not read?
But you're here.
Yes, and someone's going to pay greatly for that. I'm the Green Bean Queen. I will not be humiliated like this.
Don't be.
How can I not be humiliated? Here we are in the middle of the street, me and this stupid crown and you in that getup.
I'm the drum major.
That means nothing to me.
You know, the drum major?
Still nothing.
How about this? Ha-ta-da!
I guess you're in the band, but you don't have an instrument.
I don't need one.
If you're the drum major, aren't you supposed to have drums or something?
See, I'm the big cheese, the head honcho, the grand pooha. I'm in charge of the entire band.
Okay.
I guess you could say I'm like the king of the band, like how you're the queen of the green beans.
I am not the queen of the green beans!
Okay, then what are you the queen of?
Oh, come on. Everyone knows the green bean queen.
I've been busy at band practice.
I am the queen of the entire harvest festival.
Wait, I get it!
You do? I never understood why we need a queen for our harvest festival.
Well, she's the queen of the harvest festival. She must have harvested the most green beans.
Ew, yuck. Do you know what that would do to my nails? Like, actually.
Then what did you do to become the green bean queen?
I won a contest.
What kind of contest?
Oh, you know, the usual formal wear question and answer talent type contest.
Oh, well, what do you get to do?
I get to ride in the harvest parade float.
And after?
What do you mean?
I mean, after the parade's over. Your reign extends until next year, right?
Yes, that's correct.
So what are you going to do after the parade?
I don't know. None of the queens before me really did anything after the parade was over.
You could be the first.
But what would I do?
I like to think when you're given a leadership role, you get to use it to do some good.
What are you doing now that you're the drum major?
Thank you. Well, you see, I get to see the kids lining the parade route, listening to the music, and wishing they had an instrument of their very own. So, for a community service project, the other band members and I are getting together with the kids to teach them an instrument of their choice.
That's actually a really good idea.
It's easy to do something you're passionate about. Do you have anything you're passionate about?
Oh, I love to read.
Oh, what kind of books do you like?
All kinds. You know, science fiction, romance, drama.
Oh, so do I.
You like a good romance novel, eh, Clarence?
What can I say, Maud? I'm in love with love. I don't get to read much anymore. My eyes are getting pretty bad. Do you think you'd come and read to me sometime?
Oh, I'd love to.
And I know plenty of elderly folk like my friend Kelly who would love to have such a young person read to them.
Huh. Maybe I can get some of the girls from the contest and we can get some of the old people, senior citizens, someone paired up to read to them.
Sounds like a great idea, except for your friend Kelly.
Well, I'd love not to read with you anymore.
Well, it sounds like the Green Bean Queen knows what she's going to do after the parade.
The parade. I forgot all about it. Oh, well. I guess I'll get dressed up again next week. No big deal.
So you're not embarrassed about showing up on the wrong day?
Me? Embarrassed? I'm the Green Bean Queen. And for once, that title might mean a little bit more than riding in a parade float and wearing a crown.
And harvesting green beans?
It was never about harvesting green beans!
I knew that.
Yeah, sure you did. Anyway, if you're not busy, do you think you can help me put together something for my senior reading initiative?
Sure thing. Lead the way.
You're the drum major. You should be the one leading the way.
All right. I got this.
Oh, see you next week! So, about those romance novels, you got a favorite?
Besides that one.
This one.
They were pretty good.
Oh, those two are in love, Clarence.
Not yet, anyway.
This is a whole new side of you that I've never seen before, surprisingly. And I don't know how I feel about that.
I'm like an onion, Maud. Peel back my layers and you'll find many surprises hidden under there.
Yeah, don't ever ask me to peel you again. Oh, Trish, get those produce sprayers fixed for Barb?
Sure did, Maud. Sure did.
Wait, Trish, did you find any way to give Barb a little shower?
No, Clarence. Why would I do a thing like that to poor old Barb?
Had to ask.
Come on, Emma. Let's see if Miss Barb has some of those delicious plums you love so much. Oh, dear.
I'll just come back later. Go, 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 go.
Oh, hey, Barb.
Can't you two find somewhere else to sit and bother everyone?
Oh, come on, Barb. Don't be such a wet blanket.
Get out.
Why?
I don't want you here, clearly.
This is public property, Barb.
Does it look like I care? This is definitely you two's doing.
Sure.
We sit out here all day. How would we have done anything with your produce sprayers?
I know you're besties with Trish. What? I'm right.
Respect your elders, maybe, but...
Get out.
No.
Maybe say it nicely and I will.
Please, can you leave?
Oh, of course, Barb.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Wow, you used your manners for once.
I didn't know you know those.
Okay, move a little faster, please.
I'm moving at the pace of your sails, Barb.
Excuse you?
Get
okay,
a life, you old crone.
Whoa, that was personal. Stoplight.
Was nice.
Yeah, Polly knows how to make a good burger.
Sorry our date couldn't have been fancier for tonight.
That's okay. I didn't want to leave the kids for too long anyways.
I figured.
What's that supposed to mean?
Nothing. Forget I said anything.
Well, you did. Is there anything else you want to add?
This feels like a trap.
Why would I be setting a trap for you, Jim? I'm your wife.
Exactly.
This is about the thing from the other night, isn't it?
What thing?
You know what I'm talking about. Don't act like you don't remember.
Yep, definitely a trap.
I guess we're doing this then.
I guess we are.
You know I love your mother, right?
Whoa. Any conversation that starts like that is a bad one.
You don't see anything that isn't right under your nose, you know.
Really? How do you figure that?
I figure that every time I trip over your shoes that you apparently didn't see laying on the floor of our bedroom.
You have got to be kidding me right now.
Facts are facts.
Yeah, well, we wouldn't be having a conversation about the thing if you weren't such a control freak.
Cannot believe you just said that.
I just mean you... like things a certain way?
Is that so?
And usually your way is good?
Usually?
Okay, Sal, don't you think you're overreacting a little bit? Or not? Let's just go home.
No. We need to make a decision about the thing once and for all.
Fine.
You know, I love your mother, right?
Why are you saying that again?
Well, that thing is ugly. Like, really ugly. No, horrifying is more like it.
It's not that bad.
It's the stuff of nightmares, Jim. The face looks like a demented orangutan. And the body, if you can call it that, looks like if Big Bird and the name SpongeBob had a baby. But the worst part has to be the wings.
Are you even sure those are wings?
What else could they be?
Fair point.
We can't keep it, Jim.
Well, what else are we supposed to do?
Well, I mean to talk to you about maybe finding some for her to talk to. You know, to work out her demons or whatever.
She made it with her own two hands.
That doesn't mean we can't get rid of it. I mean, trash day is tomorrow. Or maybe we could bury it in very, very deep hollowed ground.
Yeah, and we're going to need some sage to burn over it also.
Oh, now we're talking.
What are we supposed to do when she comes over?
We'll tell her it's out being cleaned.
It's made of coffee ground and birdseed. Can you even clean something like that?
Good point. Maybe we can tell her a local art gallery is considering it for an upcoming showing. Yeah, I wouldn't believe that one either.
If she comes over and doesn't see it, she's gonna be heartbroken.
Then there's only one solution.
What?
We just don't invite your mother to our house ever again.
Nice try.
I guess we'll just have to put it on display when she comes over.
That seems fair.
But I want it put away the second she's out of there.
Deal.
Good. Let's put it in the basement. No, the garage. No, the shed. But we're going to need to burn some of that sage.
Well, this looks familiar.
Yeah, it's the site of our first date.
That wasn't a date.
Yes, it was.
We were fighting the whole time.
We literally fought tonight, and this was supposed to be a date.
Can we call a truce then?
How do we do that?
How about a dance?
So, does this mean we can't tease each other anymore?
Now, when did I say that?
Well, you're still a terrible dancer. Do you still have two left feet or something?
Oh, and I suppose the still brainiac like you could still show me a thing or two about dancing.
You know it. But we're going to need some date nights more because you have really terrible feet.
You know what I think?
What?
I think you're desperately in love with me.
Of course you do. Okay, no, right? Left. No, you're not. You're dealing with.
Well, maybe the teacher was wrong.
No, she wasn't.
Sally, wait, hang on.
No!
Have you seen this?
The new restaurant? Of course I have. Isn't it great?
You can't be serious.
A new restaurant's good for this town. We haven't had a new restaurant in... How many years has it been?
23.
Pretty sure of that number?
That's how long I've been on the town council for.
Now that makes sense.
I can't believe I got it voted again. Besides, what do we need a new restaurant for? We've got Polly's.
Polly's is great. Everyone loves Polly's. But you can still love something you've always had and be willing to open your heart up to something new.
Flash doesn't want us to open our hearts. He wants us to open our wallets.
Well, I'm going to give Flash a try. Maybe for lunch today. I'd better head over now, though. It looks pretty busy. See ya.
Better not let Polly see you over there. Traitor!
You got some pretty good specials over there.
I gotta do something. Flash is stealing all my business.
I wouldn't worry too much, Polly. There are plenty of hungry folks in town.
Yeah, well, you know how people flock to whatever's shiny and new and exciting.
True, but people also love the stable and familiar. I think there's room for stability and excitement in this town.
We'll see about that. Oh, hi. Hey there, neighbor.
Well, hello there. You must be the incomparable Polly with the best burgers and malts in town.
You heard wrong.
I'm Flash.
You can't cross. The light just changed.
But there aren't any cars in the road.
Better stay on your side of the road just in case.
Okay. So So I know we have competing restaurants and all, but I really hope we can still be friends.
Why? So you can steal my recipes?
Why would I do something like that? I'm sure your burgers are great. But I have a burger of my own that I'm pretty proud of.
Oh, really? What's on it?
Well, to start off, the patty is made from 100% Kobe beef.
I don't see what's so great about Kobe beef. Ground chuck has always been fine by me.
The patty is placed on a brioche bun spread with a scratch-made aioli.
It's mayonnaise. Why don't you fancy new chefs have to call it aioli?
Fine. The bun is spread with mayonnaise.
That's better.
Then we add some artichoke hearts, heirloom tomatoes, pea sprouts, and crispy pancetta.
Artichoke hearts? Crispy pancetta? Is this even a burger anymore?
Then to top it off, PSA de resistance, a farm fresh sunny side egg. What's so funny?
An egg on a burger. You're pulling my leg.
I'm not pulling anything.
An egg belongs on a breakfast plate, not on a burger.
I disagree. There's nothing quite like a warm, runny egg yolk dripping down the side of a juicy burger to satisfy a hungry appetite.
Yummo, that does sound good.
You can't be serious.
I imagine it's like a warm, buttery sauce for the burger.
See, good man, he gets it at least.
Simon, I get it.
Hey, don't look at me, I just got your burger.
I don't see why you new chefs have to change everything. The classic burger is fine just the way it is.
Well, sometimes change is a good thing.
I disagree.
All right, let's have a taste test. These two senior citizens seem to be connoisseurs of our creative cuisine. We can have them try each of our burgers and see which one they like best.
I mean, I've got a Polly's burger here.
Here's one of mine.
I was eating that.
Move faster, Mom.
Oh, I'm sorry. Got arthritis.
Here goes nothing.
Prepare to be destroyed. These two are loyal customers of mine for many years. They'll never choose your burger over mine.
We'll see about that.
That's a lot of pressure.
Try Polly's burger first.
This one, right?
Mm-hmm. Classic.
Delicious and flavorful.
Yummo.
That's what I thought. Now try his burger, if you can even call it that.
It's so buttery.
Surprisingly satisfying.
Yummo.
Aw, that's what I thought.
So whose burger is better?
Yeah.
Honestly, Polly, I couldn't decide. They're both great, but, you know, it's kind of hard to tell the difference. I'm kind of...
Sorry, Polly. I like them both.
I've got old taste buds, Polly.
Well, that's no help.
I never said I was going to be helpful.
You could have at least tried.
May I?
Go for it.
Mmm. Polly, this burger is amazing. I can see why the whole town loves it so much.
Let me try that.
Polly, I was eating that.
Not bad.
Ah, so you like it.
I didn't say I liked it. But I would like to know what you put in the aioli.
You mean mayonnaise.
Whatever. It's delicious.
Let's head to my kitchen and we'll whip up a batch.
Can I finish this on the way?
As long as I can finish mine.
So, which restaurant has the better fries?
I don't know about you, but I'm not getting into that one. Now fair I don't point. Have a burger.
Find better friends.
Rubber.
The wind in my hair.
Oh, this one is mine. I can just feel it. So, what are the terms?
All right, We start right here, go around the stoplight, and finish back here. First to the finish line wins.
First to swerve is chicken. Bark, bark, bark.
Silly, you know?
Yeah, well, your friend looks like a chicken. Bark.
Are you guys sure this is a good idea?
I think it's a great idea.
The best.
But this could be dangerous, you know?
So? Danger doesn't scare me. Yeah, and danger's my middle name.
Your middle name's Cornelius.
Shut up. Winston. If you haven't realized, we're in the middle of the street. There could be cars coming by. We could get hit by a bus.
So? They'll just have to go around us.
Yeah, we were here first.
Plus, we'd be way too fast when we catch anyways. Whoa, whoa, whoa. I'm faster than you.
Okay, no, I'm faster than you.
We'll see about that.
And cut. Now, that was a great take. Don't get me wrong. But, okay. It's not buck, buck. It's buck.
I didn't want to be here in the first place. I wanted to be on crew.
Just add pizzazz.
Okay, okay. I just have one quick question.
Shoot.
So what's my whole motivation for entering this track race? Like, is it for the fame and the glory, or is it for, like, the guy?
Neither.
What?
Okay. Imagine you're a little girl with a lot to prove, and no one understands the complexities that are just bubbling up within. And the only way to calm them is through the fear and excitement of the race. Understand?
I think I do.
Okay then. Back to places, everyone. Ready and action.
What are you racing for?
Pinks.
Pinks?
Pink slips. Right. Winner gets ownership of the loser's wheels.
Wait, what? No. Those, we didn't agree on this.
Well, you better be hungry, because you're about to eat my dust.
No, I thought that was my line.
So did I.
Okay. I had to make changes to the script for continuity reasons. Roll with it. Ready and action.
Well, you'll be coughing up my dust for literal days.
All right.
Okay, girls.
Save it for the race.
And cut. Good job. Take five while I reset the scene.
Hey, what's going on over here?
Oh, hey, Trish, I didn't see you there.
You guys making a movie?
Yeah, we're making one for our high school film class.
You know, there's something really familiar about your story here.
Oh, it must be because it's a dramatization of the drag race we had when we were kids.
That's it. Well, I'd love to see it when it's all done.
I'll make sure to get you tickets to the world premiere.
Please do.
Hey, Trish. You were there that day, weren't you?
Sure was.
I've got it. Would you like a little cameo within our film? It'd be super cool since you were there.
Me? A cameo?
Yeah.
Yes? I would love to. What would I have to do?
Okay, so just be yourself. But when we get here, if you could give us some of your famous advice, that'd be awesome.
All right. You sure I won't ruin your movie, though?
If you do, I'm going to edit you out anyways.
Okay, fair enough.
Okay. All right, then. Places, everyone. Trish is going to be joining us for this next scene, so improvise along with her, and we'll see how this goes.
Okay. Welcome to the set, Trish.
All right. Ready, and action.
What's going on over here?
We're about to drag race.
Is that so?
Any last minute words of wisdom, Trish?
Only this. Have fun.
That's it?
That's it. Well, you see, you have plenty of adults in your life telling you things like slow down and be careful. And those are all great things to know. But sometimes, especially as we get older, it can be hard to remember what it was like to just be a kid, excited for the thrill of the race, the feeling of wind in your hair. So if you're asking me for my advice, is to simply have fun.
I think we can do that.
I think we already are.
Looks like it to me.
And cut. Can't say that was the direction I planned on going with the scene.
You're welcome.
But I really appreciate your help, Trish.
Pleasure was all mine. You weren't really going to drag race those cars, are you?
No. That'd be way too dangerous. I actually took an After Effects course, so I'm going to edit the drag race in that way.
Sounds good. Well, I'll leave you to it.
I'll get you your tickets.
Please do.
Everyone else, back to places, please. Ready and action. Thank you.
I guess. Start your engines. Whenever you're ready.
I'm just waiting until the light turns green. Okay. Enough, girl. 3, 2, 1!
You two are still out here?
Where else will we be?
One could hope you'd be at home for a change.
Oh, not until the business day is done, Barb. You should really know that by now.
Well, the day is done, fellas. Time to get out of here.
You heard her, Mon.
A little faster this time, please.
Yeah, we're leaving.
See you tomorrow, Barb.
See you tomorrow.
Do with that.
Hmm.
Oops, I missed. Let's try again.
Learn to throw, Barb.
Oh, that wasn't good, was it? I'm gonna get you this time.
Sure.
This is your fault. You guys are watching, like.
Did she get it that time?
Yeah, slack it.
I finally done it! Barb 1, stoplight 0.
Wait, did she actually do it? My eyes just bad.
Yeah, she stopped the stoplight.
Oh my god.
You thought you had me there for a minute. That's didn't you, stoplight? All those times you flashed red at me or messed with me when I was trying to cross the street. Not so funny now, are you?
Everything all right there, Barb?
Couldn't be better. Could not be better.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I mean, I finally put a stop to this stupid stoplight, and it just took one throw.
Is no. that so?
It took
actually,
two.
Yeah,
that was like three, Barb.
Yeah, learn to count, Barb.
Yeah, I think it was three. But hey, I just swung back like so and let it loose. That didn't stand a chance.
You know that's destruction of public property, right?
What's that now? You've got to be kidding me.
Yeah. Class 4 misdemeanor. Oh, no. It's all right. I got it.
No, write them all up. Write them all up.
All of them?
Yeah.
Yeah. She well, deserves it.
Anyway, you know, I'm pretty sure you're the one who said it was a class 4 misdemeanor.
I don't remember that.
So, you know, take it.
You want this?
Why'd you crumple it up? How's
that throw it at her.
Sir, that's littering.
Look at what she did.
Yeah. Write you another one later. Anyway. Now Trish gotta come fix it. So I guess I'll just direct traffic.
There's no traffic! Do you see traffic?
No.
Do you see traffic?
No.
Because I see no traffic.
Ma'am.
Ever since that stoplight got put up, there's been zero traffic. No cars. No cars! I'm in the middle of the road. Hit me if you dare.
Ma'am.
Nobody's gonna hit me, because guess what? There's no cars. There's not even a gas station in this town.
My thoughts exactly.
You're right for once.
Well, I'll stand here anyway.
Yeah, it's almost like it's your job.
Yeah, I will write you up again.
Has the 7:30 bus come through town yet?
Oh, not yet.
Good.
Do you have everything, sweetheart?
Yes. My roommate has all the furniture set up in the dorm and everything I need, except what's in here has been shipped there already. I'm ready for college.
Okay.
I can't believe this day is finally here.
Neither can I.
It's okay, Sally. We're just sending Emma off to college. She'll come home on the weekends.
You will, won't you? You'll come home on the weekends, right?
Of course I'll come home on the weekends.
Oh, thank goodness.
I'm gonna have laundry.
I never thought I'd be so happy to wash your smelly old laundry.
It's safe to cross, Casey.
I will. Just give me a minute.
Don't worry. She'll cross when she's ready.
That's right. I'm almost ready. I promise.
We've heard that before.
Mm-hmm. Dirty bus come through town yet?
Not yet.
Oh, good.
Where are you heading to? Running away from small town life?
Not that I'm running away from this town. More like I'm running towards something.
I like that. It makes me feel a lot better about going.
Oh, me too.
Well, that's as good a reason as I've ever heard.
Thanks, Clarence.
And what happened to the stoplight?
Oh, Barb's a criminal now! It's out to get me, I tell you!
Was it, though?
Destruction of public property and all.
It's all right. I'll have it fixed in no time.
I'll leave it to you, Trish.
Oh, wow, that really was no time.
Are you sure you should have fixed that stoplight? You, could have just taken it down, you know.
Nice try, Barb.
Well, we don't even need this stupid stoplight. We never have any traffic come through this town.
But we could, Barb. We could. And the way I see it, if you have something that's a symbol for greater hope to come, you should hang on to it, don't you think?
I think I'm ready now.
Really?
Got yourself a green light, Casey.
Time to go.
Go, Casey.
She's actually doing it.
Oh, wow.
Oh, God.
She's going to do this?
I've been waiting my whole life for this.
Maybe longer.
I did it.
In your own time.
Great job, Casey.
Thank you.
Go buy me those lemon candies.
No.
Well, there's the 7:30 bus.
Time to go.
Good luck at college.
I love you, Emma.
Good luck in the big city.
Thanks, Clarence.
Good luck in the big city!
I already said that, Mom.
Oh, so what? I can wish him well, too.
No, you can't.
Yes,
thank
I
you
can.
Both.
No.
Well, I just did.
Stoplight still stands.
It sure does.
You know why I like it so much, Barb?
No, but I'm sure you're going to tell me.
Mm-hmm. I like the changing of the colors from green to yellow to red. Sometimes we're expecting the change, like when the light's yellow telling us to slow down. We know red's just around the corner.
But I hate that red light.
But sometimes if we get distracted or we're not paying close enough attention, the colors can change so quick that we almost miss it. Turning green, telling us it's time to go.
So quickly.
Like the blink of an eye.
These colors watch over our little town. They know where we've been and where we're going. They keep us safe, telling us when to go and when to stop. Kind of like now.
Like now?
Look around, Barb. The day is done. It's time to go home. Green, yellow, red. Go, slow down, stop.
I hopped off the plane at LAX with a dream, my cardigan. Welcome to the land of fame, excess. Am I gonna fit in? Jumped in the cab, here I am for the first time. Look to my right and I see the Hollywood sign. This is all so crazy. Everybody seems so famous. My tummy's turning and I'm feeling kinda homesick. Too much pressure and I'm nervous. That's when the taxi man turned on the radio. And the Jay-Z song was on. And the Jay-Z song was on. And the Jay-Z song was on. So I put my hands up to play my song. The butterflies fly away. Club in my taxi cab, everybody's looking at me now. Like, who's that chick that's rocking kicks? She gotta be from out of town.